Loopy loves playing with his teddy bear. His name is Teddy. One day, Loopy was really worried when he couldn't find Teddy anywhere. "He's gotta be here somewhere," cried Loopy, as he frantically dug through his messy room. Losing Teddy was horrible, because tomorrow was show and tell, and Loopy told everyone at school that he was going to bring Teddy. "Maybe I left Teddy somewhere else," he thought. Loopy zoomed out of his room. "Don't worry, Teddy, I'll find you," he shouted. Junior and Thea were playing outside when they saw Loopy running toward them in a panic. "Loopy, are you okay?" asked Junior. Loopy had been running so fast he had to catch his breath. "I can't find Teddy anywhere, and tomorrow is show and tell, and he's lost and all alone, and what if evil aliens from planet Icky Broccoli took him and are holding him prisoner?" "Don't worry, Loopy," said Junior, comforting his little brother. "You just left him somewhere and you don't remember where." Theo opened and read from his book. "If you lose something, the best thing to do is retrace your steps." "Do you remember all the places you went to today?" asked Junior. Loopy thought really hard. "I think so." Loopy remembered he had gone to the drinking fountain because he was thirsty. "I put Teddy right here on the grass," he recalled. "But he isn't here anymore. Maybe I left him at the ice cream shop. I went there too." The kids decided to split up so they could look around the fountain one more time before they all met at the ice cream shop. Theo even had a detective's magnifying glass so he could look for clues on the way there. When Loopy and Junior arrived at the ice cream shop, they were surprised to see that Theo had gotten there first. "Theo, did you find Teddy?" asked Junior. "Nope, but I did find this delicious strawberry ice cream," he replied. "Maybe Teddy is inside the ice cream shop," said Loopy. They looked under the tables, behind the counter, and even asked the ice cream man if anyone had found Teddy. No such luck. Teddy was still nowhere to be found. "At least the ice cream was good," said Theo while he licked the leftovers off his lips. "Where else have you been today?" asked Junior. "Next, I went to the pool," said Loopy with excitement. Loopy started to run down the sidewalk. "Follow me," he shouted. "Hey, wait up," Junior and Theo both yelled, chasing after Loopy. When Loopy got to the pool, he was worried that Teddy accidentally fell in the water. Loopy asked Theo if he could help, but the strange thing about Theo is he doesn't like swimming, which is quite unusual for a turtle. They didn't find Teddy, but they sure had a good laugh with Theo about his fear of water. The only other place Loopy had gone to that day was the woods behind the playground. Just before they went into the woods, they found Kate climbing a tree. "Hey guys, what you doing down there?" she asked. "We are looking for Loopy's Teddy," explained Junior. "Can you help us?" Kate jumped down from the tree lickety-split. "You betcha," she said. "I love solving mysteries. Let's go." They peeked under rocks and stuck their heads in bushes. They found birds and butterflies, but still no sign of Loopy's favorite teddy bear. "Are you sure Teddy isn't at home?" asked Junior. "I already looked everywhere at home," he replied. Theo had one more idea, though. "Sometimes it helps if a friend looks for something in the same place you already looked," he suggested. "They might see things you didn't notice." everyone thought Theo's idea was amazing. They decided to go back to Loopy's house and see if he had missed something. Mom! Exclaimed Loopy. Have you seen Teddy anywhere? His mom hadn't seen Teddy, but she had a good idea where he might be. Why don't we go take a look in your room? She suggested. When Loopy and his mom arrived at his room, they had to push the door really hard because there was a giant pile of toys blocking the way. I have a sneaky suspicion that Teddy is hidden underneath all these toys, said his mom. Loopy didn't argue because she was probably right. Junior and Theo wondered how they were ever going to start looking for Teddy. Kate wasn't scared, though. The best way to start anything is by jumping in, she yelled, diving headfirst into Loopy's mess. Everyone was worried about Kate because she didn't come up for a long time. Is everything okay in there, Kate? Junior called out. Just then, Kate jumped up with Teddy in her hands. Ta-da! She shouted. Mystery solved! Loopy was so happy to have Teddy back. Now he could bring him to school. Thank you so much, he gratefully told his friends. You're welcome, but maybe you should take better care of Teddy from now on, suggested Junior. Mom, I got Teddy back! See? Exclaimed Loopy, holding Teddy up in the air. Loopy's mom was very happy that Teddy was safe, but she had one important thing to say. Before you take Teddy to school tomorrow, you need to clean your room. While Loopy picked up his toys, he realized how important it was to keep his room clean. I'll never lose you again, Teddy, he promised. The end.
In morning, they go for a walk. In the supermarket, they buy apples. The apple is red. They buy carrots too. The carrot is orange. And last of all, they buy bananas. The banana is yellow. Let's see the colors again. Orange. Yellow. In the afternoon, they go for a walk. Diana sees some fish in the fountain. The fish is blue. The frogs are sunbathing in the pond. The frog is green. They sit and watch the clouds in the sky. The cloud is Let's see the colors again. White, green, later on, they buy an ice cream. Which flavor do you want? Diana asks for a strawberry ice cream. The ice cream is pink. Her grandma wants a chocolate ice cream. Chocolate is brown. Pink. Brown. On their way home, Diana is really happy. She loves being with her grandma. The sky is indigo. Diana gives her grandma a goodnight kiss. Brown, pink, white. Yellow. Orange. Green.